who signed the letter of suspension, distinguished members, I have attached as an annexure to the letter of suspension was personally signed by the Honorable Minister, personally signed by her, who set up the administrative panel of inquiry. The administrative panel of inquiry was set up by the Honorable Minister. The DG was invited to appear before that panel, and he appeared before that panel, to my knowledge, on the 8th of January. He received a letter dated 3rd of January, asking him to appear on the 10th of January, and he did appear before that panel, made written submissions, including some of the allegations with the greatest respect that were used as a decoy to remove him, including the one that has to do with 104 million naira, which he will address. With respect, I'm just being fair and firm, like the chairman said. Admin panel is a personnel of staff of CERC supposed to appear before an administrative panel of the minister? No. Distinguished members, section 313 of the Investment and Securities Act confers on CERC the powers to make laws, subsidiary legislations, and one of them they made, which chapter 16 of the public service rule say they can make, is their staff manual. The staff manual gives the conditions if a staff of SEC, this directly applies to the two SEC staff. It says if a senior staff of SEC is in breach of so misconduct, and they articulated the levels of the staff, these are what you would do. If you breach that subsidiary legislation, you have breached section 313 of the law. You have breached section 313 of the law. You have breached a law of the National Assembly because it is delegated legislation. And the law is that once those powers of the National Assembly gave them the power of delegation and they have made it. So if you look at those manual, no employee of SEC out to be tried or asked to appear before an administrative panel of the minister, because there's already an inbuilt mechanism. And then the law is to avoid confusion.
DG, I want to appeal that you focus on the suspended DG. Were the two other staffs invited to the panel? Hello, were you invited to the panel, madam? You were invited to the panel, too. Okay.
Then, distinguished members of these hallowed chambers, the Investment and Securities Act, to my knowledge, in fact, I chaired one of the subcommittees in making that law, did not draw, the legislature did not intend to draw any line between suspension and removal. There is no difference in the enabling law, and I have the law here, sir, that makes any difference between the law. It anticipates that if you must remove the DG of SEC, and in fact we debated it in subcommittee, you must have a court judgment that pronounces him guilty, or he admits that he's guilty of a crime, because you're talking about the DG of a regulatory agency, just like honorable members. Somebody comes and says, oh, there is an allegation somewhere, you are suspended from your seat as representing XYZ constituency, go and face this panel, when they clear you come back. That ought not to be. So that was what the law envisaged and said, for there to be a suspension, it must be from Mr. President, not the minister, and the minister can only recommend. And then even if when she recommends, the president will look at it, send it to the Senate, because remember, sir, that the appointment of the DG was confirmed by the Senate. It's a separate political appointment. Even the appointment as an executive commissioner, which he was prior to this period, is a separate political appointment that went through the Senate, distinguished Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, for confirmation. That separate things. So that was the intent of the law. And I still have notes of our subcommittees on, in that respect.
Thank you, sir.
Has the panel submitted a report? I'm not in a position to know. Did he appear? Yes, he did appear. He informed me the morning he was going. And in fact, I followed him to that panel, and they refused me audience, regrettably.
Thank you. please. Hold on. Can you hold?
One question, right?
Yeah, I am aware he did address some questions.
Yes.
But please, just note them. Please. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair. The issue of who is the chairman of the panel, we need to know who the chairman of the panel is, and who are those staff that you are referring to? Are they their own personal staff or staff of the ministry? Then the issue that was asked by my colleague on the issue of whether you are seeing the DG as the staff of the staff of the SEC, or perhaps maybe which means that or an appointment basis, which means that those rules that are laid there for staff, do they apply to him or not? You need to clear those
up. Hello. The DG of SEC is not an employee of SEC, so the stack manual does not apply to him. What applies to him is the what I'm talking about, the stamp manual on discipline. What applies to him is the enabling law, which is the Investment and Securities Act, upon which he was appointed, subject to further answers that he will prefer in that respect. And then I was informed, further answers that he would give, that the members of the panel constituted public civil servants in the ministry. Not, I don't know whether the ministry staff generally or personal staff of minister. I'll be surprised if they are the personal staff. One will envisage there will be officials in the ministry, perhaps the permanent secretary and all that.
Sorry, let's be progress, please. Let's be progress. The question was asked because of your presentation.
Yes.
Because you said her personal staffs. That was why they asked you that question.
No, I said staff of the ministry. Staff of the ministry.
Hello, that's not going to argue. You maybe it was a slip of tongue. You did refer them to our personal staffs.
I'm sorry.